Whoa, legendary!
What is up guys, Chris05 here with a quick as well as detailed guide on Hearthstone Deck Tracker. In this video, I will show you how you can use this amazing program to its full potential. I have to say, some of these features almost feel like cheating, but Blizzard is fine with it, so there's no real reason for you not to use it. I'm not sponsored by HS Deck Tracker, I just think everyone should use this cool add-on and know about all of its features. Watch the video to the end and you will learn how you can see your turn timers, win percentages, board damage and much more. Feel free to ask me questions about it in the comment section too. You can be sure I will do my best to answer each and every one of you. Okay, now let's get into it. As you probably know, HS Deck Tracker is only available for Windows and Mac, which for me is a huge setback for mobile players, and that is why I prefer to only go ranked from my computer. I won't go wasting your time with explaining how to download and install the program, as it is fairly simple. I will just leave a link in the description so you can find it easier. Also, this picture should really give you a good idea of what Deck Tracker does if you are not familiar with the program. I just want to include that it also gives you all of the possible secrets that your opponent might have played, and it removes the secrets that you already have tested for from the pool, which is amazingly helpful for new and for old players alike. Once you start the program, you will see something like this, and as soon as you start a Hearthstone game, the deck tracker will automatically fetch the information for your deck and display it most of the time. If for some reason that doesn't happen, you can copy your deck code and import it in your deck tracker so it knows exactly what deck you're using. After that, you can right-click the deck and click on Use Deck. You can also copy a deck code while you're mid-game if you want to share your deck with someone. You just have to select the deck, click Export to Hearthstone, and you can copy everything or just copy the code for easy sharing. Another thing you can do is archive or delete your old decks, so you can have an easier time finding the decks you actually play. All you have to do is mark the decks you want to archive or delete, and go to Deck, Archive or Delete. If you archive the deck, it will show up in this folder thingy right here. I have to say, I just noticed this function, but I will put it to good use because I have been using this tool for almost 2 years and things are getting pretty crowded. I will definitely clear my arena, dungeon and brawl decks because those just get in my way. Okay, enough with the basic stuff, let's get into the options. From here, you can upload your collection and you can share your collection with others from the HS Replay website. You just log on to it, go to My Data and click My Collection. You have to make it public and now you can share your link with whoever you want and they will be able to see your collection. There, you have a bunch of filters you can use for easy searching through your cards. This is really helpful when you're trying to build a deck from your collection with the help of a friend. After you've uploaded your collection, you can actually find the meta decks for which you have most of the cards, just by pressing this big button. That will take you back to the site, and you can see a bunch of stats for the decks you can afford, which is really neat. Hearthstone Deck Tracker also has a built-in replay system, which is cool if you wish to watch your replays after a game or share it with someone. But if you rather save some computer power and internet, you can turn off the auto-upload replays from Options, Replays, Upload Automatically. If you wish to watch your replays, you go back to the site and go to My Data, My Replays. Here is how the simplified playback looks like. You can also copy the code and share your game with whoever you want. By the way, you can use Hearthstone Deck Tracker as proof of winning a World of Duels game too. You can just share your replay in case of a dispute and that will be enough proof for you to take your cash. Check them out if you still haven't. Now let's move down to the overlay general options. A lot of people ask me how I have this cool timer on my deck tracker during my streams, and from here you can activate it. Just untick the Hide Timers box and that will fire up the timer. I find it very useful since I like to know exactly how much time I have during my turn. It also shows how much time you and your opponent have taken to make your plays too, which is also kinda cool. From here you can also resize your overlay and reposition it if you like. You just unlock it, mess around with it and lock it back in. After you screw it up, you can just click the reset button, so don't worry. In the overlay player options, you can find a very powerful tool, namely Show Board Attack Counter. This is one of the best features for lazy people like me, because it counts your board damage for you, including your equipped weapon. This makes missing lethal so much harder, but I still manage to do it from time to time, so it is not completely idiot-proof. Keep in mind, it won't count your hero power and your hand damage, but just the damage you already have on the board, which in some cases really saves you a lot of time, and hints you to start looking for lethal too. From the checkboxes from the bottom part, you can tick Wins, so you can see your wins with a certain deck, right above your deck. I suggest you tick everything else too, since it also gives you useful information like the chance you have to draw a certain card, for instance, or the amount of fatigue damage you will take on your next draw. In the opponent section, you have almost the same options. Here, you can tick your opponent's damage counter too, so you know exactly how much damage he has on the board. This will also save you a lot of time while you think how you can prevent his lethal next turn, so make sure to activate it. From the bottom option, you can tick the win rate, so Deck Tracker shows you what is your win rate against every class. This is very useful, since it helps you choose your playstyle for each class. If you have a really low win rate, you will probably have to play very greedy on the mulligan and take risks with your plays. And if you have a good win rate, you can just play it safe and stack another win. The only other option worth mentioning here is in the Notifications tab. From there you can disable the annoying pop-up window for arena rewards after each arena run, so you don't have to close it every time. So that's it for the options. Last but not least, you can check detailed stats for your deck performance from the stats section. You can see your previous matches, your stats, a bunch of charts, both arena and for constructed, and you can tinker around with the filters too. Tick active deck only so you see your stats for the current deck you're using. So that's it for this video, guys. Drop a like if you found this helpful and subscribe if you're new. It really means a lot to me. Feel free to point out if I missed something important too. Thanks for watching. I'm Chris05 and I'll see you in my next video.